We've already said
we had a real good little rhythm section going in those days, and we went down really well, you know.
So I said, Moody, M&B, Blue, Moody Blues, Moody Blues 5.
Sure, I put the blues bit in there, and I was probably the moody one. So there you go, Michael. That was a great part of the set, but I wanted it to be a little bit more original.
We were in the process of running out of steam.
Well, they screwed us for every penny. The big difference between band one and band two was the songs, how powerful Justin's writing was.
All people who are in love have a huge desire to tell the world about it.
Everyone's dream is to write a standard, and I think that song is a standard.
America loved it right off, and I think that was really the main reason for our second try of success.
So by the time we'd got to California, we'd really created quite a buzz.
They could play to four times the size of audiences because they had the stadiums in the States long before we did.
The most important thing for me is to maintain a calma about the music and about what I write about.
Nights in white satin,
da 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 da,
never reaching the end,
da 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 da.
We found ourselves in sympathy with the generation because we were that generation.
Timothy Lee was dead. No, he's outside looking in. What's that mean?
LSD and all that. Who knows?
There seemed to be people who had the ability of good tunesmiths with a presentation which was confidently classy.
They've had an incredible renaissance in the States.
It was driven by this Berlin blues band, which went on to bigger things.
Are you a heavy rock band? Are you a folk band? Are you underground? Are you progressive? Are you psychedelic? The answer to that is real simple. We're all of those with the Moody Blues.